that way I don't have to come back.
It's like a thing.
I've known Cody for a really long time.
Oh.
He's been messaging me on Facebook like all day. You don't like him?
No, he thinks Heidegger's a good argument.
He was like the first person that ever gave me like my first communication.
Was it Heidegger?
No, it was Nietzsche.
Oh, sorry.
Even better.
That's so much better.
And then I like thought I was like an actually good K debater because for a while I had like overviews, underviews, and answers that were already written for me and read the same argument all the time. But like, yeah, actually I'm a pretty good K debater. Turns out that's not true.
That's not true. Not like the one card extension. Look at these sick front lines.
Girl, no cards. I was too slow for the people in high school policy, so
oh, no.
It was just like, and you can see the warrants. I didn't believe in cards. Sorry, Judge doesn't round E and was almost 10 minutes late to the round.
I should probably.
Oh, no.
You should stop blaming or outblaming.
Nah,
she's
also
stop blaming probably.
Yeah.
I do gotta say, though, him breaking his hand was pretty clutch.
Oh, yeah. Are you kidding me? That was the move.
Yeah, he seems to be in recurrent pain then. They'll be slowing down for him.
He's trying to flow with his opposite hand, apparently, on this round.
Wow. Poor guy. Oh. Yeah. Poor debaters in that round. I wouldn't love to do
it. It'd be like slow. Okay.
Why doesn't he just type?
He said that it like hurts his wrist to like bend, so he can't type.
And he's one of those things that like translates all of the words into.
Yeah, that I don't really never be able to do technically.
Sorry, my phone wasn't telling me where I was supposed to go, and then I found out it was broken, and then I really was close.
That's a small mess.
I thought I just needed that extra to
return. No.
Is it because they don't read extensions in the MO? Because we can verify.
Oh my god!
That was
bitch.
Seriously?
That was savage.
Jesus.
No, look, so really good.
They were so busy trying to explain things so we actually understood them that they failed to exclude us.
Send us some paper.
Yeah.
But I already know I'm voting against Pacific, so I don't know what to do.
Steve.
The Steve, yeah.
Thank you.
So you get cheese or anything next?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Cool. Observation 1 is the best analysis. Today's resolution of the United Nations substantially increases funding water filtration production developing nations views criteria. A is that the judge, the public intellectual, who should divide with the bound as a matter of competing worldviews. Once again, the judge, the public intellectual, should divide with the bound as a matter of competing worldviews. The first argument is the field is illusory. Obviously, the plan doesn't actually happen, so it's only a question of how we advance. Hypothetical language can be our speech, technical, psychological, aesthetics, form, epistemology. We necessarily say that only the world are able to orient ethically towards other individuals who are not necessarily ourselves. Can we actually impose ethics while can we allow for ethics to exist? But the second or third argument is the benefit of its law for ethical evaluations. We necessarily say the consequences are absolutely key to evaluating ethical orientations, i.e., that if your plan were justified to killing 1 million people to save 1 million more people, that would necessarily be bad. And if the fourth argument is debate is a training ground, we say the debate is necessary for critical contestation site. It means a lot of stuff just doesn't come up in the real world. So basically, observation 2 is inherent. The first argument is the United Nations has adopted a policy 7 years ago to make water a human right. The eighth point is that in 2010 it was recognized that water, clean access to water should be a human right across all nations of the world. But the second argument is despite this attempt to increase the access to clean water, a significant amount of people still go out. 2.5 billion people in the world as of right now, according to the last census from the WHO, it can go without water whatsoever. If you use the plan text, the United Nations should substantially increase its funding of water filtration and production to all developing South Asian countries. By fully funding the implementation of pods for peace ceramic water filters, once again, the United Nations should substantially increase the funding of water filtration and production to all developing South Asian countries by fully funding the implementation of pods for peace ceramic water filters. So, obviously, the first argument is normal means. The United Nations should currently define South Asia as a region containing Afghanistan, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Nepal, Bhutan, and that leads to the second argument of normal means, the process of pods for peace, i.e., that they go in and establish facilities and train individuals on how to have sustainable practices in terms of being able to produce the pods for themselves. So necessarily means that they just pull out what they effectively have to people train themselves because it becomes sustainable. The second argument is description of pods for peace, filtration, and water production process. We say that necessarily create a ceramic pot with stable filter, 99.98% of water contaminates it, costs $5 to $10 a day for the next argument. That makes it inevitably sustainable because these communities can. You only have to replace it every 2 years, which necessarily means it's incredibly low cost. The fourth argument here is, and let me say it's key to a community focused ethic, i.e., not just saying we'll fix it for you, we will help you fix it for yourself. Then go to public law. Is the problem of water is lacking in South Asia now due to lack of production filtration? The first argument is the problem of water is lacking out in South Asia. The C7 would be 8.1 here is that 20% of individuals in South Asia currently lack access to any water whatsoever, and another 45% lack access to clean water. But the second argument is the problem of water would continue to be lacking. The 8th point is that the industrial development occurring in many of these regions, such as India, has led to water being poisoned via things like chemicals spill off and runoff. The third argument is now much critical time to say that the South Asian Research Foundation found that 1.6 billion people in India and 22 of 32 cities in India are currently lacking any access to clean water, but the beast point of the plan solved by providing filters and water production. The one point is that these pumps drastically reduce the waterborne disease rates. We have already made this announcement, 99.98%. The second night, the plan ensures there will be significant increase in bottled water production. The eighth point is that, according to the WHO, this will allow them to meet 85% of the needs for all citizens at the lowest estimate. But the third argument is the plan solves over. We say it's destined to allow for other areas that are currently developing. You don't have the funds to be able to afford other forms of filtration. So use the journal links. Possible filtration is critical to increasing access to pump water. The one argument is that abuse of water-related illness. The eighth point is that water-related illness globally is a top 2 killer of individuals. The second argument is that after plant disease will also be continuing to see the development of antibiotics and bacteria. Necessarily means that we have to be able to filter out the bacteria rather than attempt to solve for an after-effect medicine. These are the effects. We say water-related illness and death. The eighth point is that who said 3.4 million people die each year as a result of lack of water access. The eighth point is that 1.6 billion children also die simply from diarrhea as a result of the water being contaminated. The third argument is that we say that in South Asia alone, 842,000 people died in 2012 as a result of being unable to access water that was sufficiently clean. And then it's you incorrect. A is that the United Nations credit for this lacking after lack of coordinating water infrastructure projects. The first argument is that human credit levels now due to lack of coordinated infrastructure development. The eighth point is that Robert Mugabe, the president of Zimbabwe, has specifically called an AU meeting in 2015 for the United Nations to be engaged within the region in terms of humanitarianism. And they should expect us to be able to trust the peacekeepers with the second arm of the United Nations credibility continues to be low. We necessarily say that the military focus as of right now is damaging the issues of collaboration that I still want to collaborate. That's what all we're trying to do. Or rather, with them. And all they're trying to do is be able to expand militarily. The third arm is now critical. The UN officials are currently looking for evidence that the UN can act effectively to gain support for operations in the D. Democratic Republic of the Congo. The A support is that municipal fire report saying that the UN would also be instrumental in preventing the doing genocide of the Eslin tents that are currently in the region, but currently people don't want them there as a result of the perception that they currently have in the international community. Links. Plan solves for UN credibility. The first charm is to plan solves for UN credibility by showing that the UN can build communities via water infrastructure. I have the idea that we will get in and help solve the problem and via a community approach rather than imposing ourselves upon the region. The second argument is plan spills over into regions like Africa, specifically in the DRC, where we talked about. The third argument is spotlights positive UN action, which is critical to building positive perception of them, i.e., that people actually willing to engage the UN and fund it and provide the internal links here, which we'll get to. The internal links is that high UN credibility allows for continued UN access to Africa. The first argument is that after the plan, the UN loses support and stops pursuing the peacekeepers. We have an indication that a variety of countries have also been trying to withdraw their ability to support the UN in terms of providing actual troops and members of the peacekeeping force to be able to go into the regions, including humanitarian efforts, just to be the UN in a necessarily nefarious way as of right now. But the second argument is the United Nations peacekeepers are key to protecting civilians. We've necessarily highlighted that there have been a variety of instances where the UN refused to actually send peacekeepers in the first place, and it has resulted in genocide, which necessarily means that allowing for peacekeepers to be in the region to be able to solve via the systemic issues that you're combining with community is necessarily going to be key impacts. The first impact of genocide, we say that there's been an ongoing conflict within the DRC dating all the way back to 1994, and this is an articulation that says this genocide will continue after the ability to actually intervene in the region. This is actually one of the main reasons that people have been critical of the UN as of now, because they refuse to engage in this region when it began to happen in the first place. We would say that the DRC rebels will continue to commit the ongoing genocide of 800,000 individuals who have already died, which means that especially try or die in order to be able to sit in the United Nations to be able to establish an ethnic responsibility positive frame and to be able to combat the rebels which are killing 800,000 people, which is a really bad thing.
If Vietnam is not real, how do we weigh your ass?
It's a question of evaluating competing cultures, right? That people get to advance like a speech act for something that affects the view of the world.
So you should value what we say in the PMC and talk about.
Okay, so should we evaluate the PMC based upon the benefits that raised by the speech act or the impacts that you can put on the page?
We say by the impacts.
Okay, so you can link this as if that's what you're going for.
My question is, like, how does your speech act solve, like, genocide?
We're saying it's a question of the worldview. Obviously, nothing we do in this room can actually solve for genocide, but questioning of pausing ourselves ethically oriented towards these individuals is necessarily a good thing.
Okay, what does it mean to ethically posture yourself towards individuals?
To ethically orient ourselves?
Yeah.
It's a question of recognizing that, like, while we may be very privileged and live in a place where there's things like great water, these people don't. And so it's probably good to have an advocacy which would advance the ability for them to have that.
Okay, that's fair. You said just the Southeastern countries, correct?
No, just South Asian.
South Asian countries. Do you have a list of what countries those
are? Yeah, I can repeat that for you. Yeah. Under the normal means, according to the United Nations definition, that is Afghanistan, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Nepal, Bhutan, and Maldives.
Okay, good. You say that the peacekeepers are key. Why?
Well, we say that, one, historically when they've gone into regions, they've been able to, like, prevent things from happening, but two, just because the UN has refused to engage in the first place allows genocides that are currently ongoing.
Okay, so what about the Haiti water filtration in the 90s, which peacekeepers, like, purposely put malaria in the water? How are peacekeepers effective if they put diseases in water that they give to people?
We're saying, one, that they don't do that now. That's like
literally. Oh, so you'll defend that peacekeepers are good now?
Yeah, that's
fine. Okay, okay.
I mean, peacekeepers are good.
It's too off, and then not.
Y'all good?
Yeah.
Thank you.
versus the interpretation of funding only means money. Once again, the new interpretations of funding only means money. The violations they deal with the canal that they build formalities for pause an extra reason for first off, the limits of layers. You explode the limits that by long for any articulation about what in particular about water structures will be underneath here. That makes it possibly be negative. We just absolutely know link all of our disads and absolutely rings that we'll see underneath here. And the decreasing amount of actual ground that we have access to is, i.e., the fact that we don't get access to offenses relegated on the idea of giving access to funding, i.e., in the past that the UN has been particularly bad in funding industrial policies, which means you just sidestep all of our offenses. The second reason for us out of education underneath here is you absolutely decrease the amount of education for two reasons. First off, you decrease the amount of clash that happened in the debate around education, and clashes internally with the way the education people to articulate itself because we aren't able to have as far as it. The second is that you also can see there's a topic specific on education, i.e., that we don't have access to be able to or allow for articulate ideas about why the UN is particularly bad for the instance the idea. You simply would just say that you know link out of that offense and would never make it possible to be negative. That's a core voting reasons for this education. Next off. First is the framework, that's the epistemological orientation conversable link underneath here. There's no way to separate the epistemological underlyings from the ways that the justification of the PNC happened will be underneath here. Cornell West says there's absolutely no way that you can allow for the true claims of anything to be validated without first allowing for methodological underpinnings the way that happens. So that means that, the little thing underneath here, that means that if the links and the impacts are actually true, the criticism, and that absolutely is the independent reason why the ethics they have or independently something's bad. The second,
do you want to put the double line? Okay, the next set of links.
The first argument is the ass investment to broken system politics. The link underneath here is the ass idea that the minor reforms the way the system politics happens, it would produce a massive change. Absolutely, growing lapses to the system of liberal politics and allows for its instigation to happen. Will be underneath here is that. That is absolutely that. That leads to two implications. First, it's the form of cruel optimism in which you instantiate the people who are most affected by your policy to somehow be able to instantiate their ideas. The second implication it also does is it also locks the judges into the economies in which the ballot represents the economy being able to obtain the. In fact, it means you're not that necessarily towards all your ethical considerations because it means that we are able to have a hand. There is a double bind. Either you absolutely extend the sovereignty of the United Nations by allowing for the passing of the plan to happen, which would only allow for the expansion of liberalism to happen, or it means the app absolutely doesn't solve just the internal link claims that you make about how this actually is seen relative to other ideas that happen. That means that the act of liberalism necessarily would only be able to reach the achieve it, and that absolutely turns the app. One reason why it turns the app because liberalism in the history of it is absolutely not being good for historical projects in the way that we have it. It's just a cry for the way that Western action people do. But the second link is that your call for action for credibility for the your call for action for credibility is absolutely call for the liberal state to re-justify their oppression only underneath here is that the app is just an extension of the gaze of liberalism for the U.S. to intervene into Southeast Asian countries that lots of the happen will be underneath here. This is empirically and historically proven. The United States have absolutely used things like liberal politics, like water justification to go into problems. You can the UN has absolutely done it. We have a couple examples of this being true. The first off is the Haiti water collection, which you have already isolated as being something that's really true. The second is that peacekeepers with the United Nations have also allowed for articulations of sexual assault happening. And others, the third is that the peacekeepers also go into Middle Eastern countries and told men in the area where that they absolutely were not protected by their isolation because of the cultural norms they were able to do. It means that you just allow for an intervention. That will be underneath here. That turns, yeah, it means liberalism absolutely. It allows for instance. Those politics happen means that you don't result in anything, thus the impact. First is that of otherization will be underneath here is liberalism creates an ontological category of the other and the non-other will be underneath here is liberalism teaches that you must have someone who's actively working against us and actively working for us to allow for reproduction the way the liberalism is able to have a political economy to happen. We'll see underneath here that makes disposable populations inevitable because there must always be someone who's working against someone who's working with will be underneath here that turns the app and means disposable populations become inevitable. We will articulate that turns the app specifically because your articulation about the way the genocide and water project happen will be the people who are most affected by the structure. Those policy actions thus.
Vote negative as a rejection into the Lenny C's attachment to liberal subjecthood. Once again, vote negative Vote negative as a rejection into the Lenny C's attachment to liberal subjecthood. Here's your copy. Sorry.
Next is the alternative. The first is the alternative. It's also laying underneath here. Don't understand how liberalism operates. The first step to be able to do with the laying underneath here is it's a sequencing question. Re-articulation is the app as a good way to the possibility of politics happen, but the liberalism absolutely is a prior question. The way that we are operated will be underneath here. And refusing calling for state expansion absolutely allows for rupturing discourse that happened in liberalism too. But future speech, your force office is a literal intervention. The way the PNC is allowed for an intervention and introduction of liberalism in the debate space. The second is it also allows for radical possibility, allows for discussion of past. The way that liberalism happens is the alternative. alternative is also a process of active rejection of the city's power relations to the land underneath your deliverables, and that absolutely currently unsustainable now. Two implications of being sure. First off, is that deans of populations or deans of actively someone who works against and someone who works for them. This means that the liberalism can never sustain itself and be able to work in the second. And it also starts to the Western colonial standpoint. It's that we must be able to have imperialism that first means liberalism will never be able to have next, and no permutation. First, and the permutation absolutely masking the land underneath your and that ultimately leads to a core cruel optimism that return all your ass off and seeing the people who are most affected by the policy will not be able to benefit any reaction. Second, and the second argument underneath here.
You sure?
Yeah.
I still have C41.
You're good.
Okay. Good app.
Yes.
Starting with the top.
The first argument is that current ethics are a Western concept and actually leads to whitewashing European seat of the land underneath here. Ethics have only been introduced in the recent 21st century as a conceptualization of politics out of the land underneath here. We can see how religion specifically is co-opted the way that ethics and ethical reactions are able to re-insert states. We'll see underneath that will be turned to you out because if it's true that religion Western concepts are where that allows for the derivatives of how we should evaluate your impacts and you do not be able to have the next argument. There's no way to determine ethics. Our first argument underneath here is concepts that ethics are not something that are prescriptive or descriptive, but rather there's something that every change will be underneath. That means that it makes the policy be negative because they have described that we should determine ethics as the possibility of the app, which means that we are not able to have the next argument in this turn. But in any case, you can change the way the system operates or those who are in power, but until you offer dismantling of the system, happen, you've never offered to be the change of the underneath here. That means the alternative is much more preferable to the BNC because if we offer dismantling the way the liberals and will operate, the app will absolutely never be able to do anything. It will be underneath here. That also means the sequence question we articulate, we will articulate them until we offer dismantling those systems to happen. We will never be able to instantiate the way that the app happens. Anything else on framework?
Go to framework. Okay. Go to the advantage.
The first argument is that we're going to extend across all of our peacekeepers bad here. Our articulations and solvency take out. We say that we have articulated that peacekeepers have historically been bad in the truth. You are not making a descriptive warrant about how peacekeepers in this one instance should be good, which means that you should absolutely evaluate the description form of history over the prescriptive form of just the PNC and saying that they solve. You should hold them accountable for the PNC research that they absolutely did not do, which means that you don't just say that peacekeepers suddenly start to be better because they're going to a different region. It means you're not able to reach me as which means that which means it solves the terminal deficits the way that the apps able to orientate themselves. The second argument, the next argument that you say on the top of the app is that those nations would necessarily be able to peel off the system and offer benefits to have. And we have two implications of this being true. Why this is not true? The first off is that the app would absolutely not allow for long-term sustainability. Two reasons why. First off is because it doesn't allow for adaptation the way the water access happens in Asia. You just give them temporary water access, don't allow for any form of long-term stability. That is exactly the role of liberalism, which justifies that we can intervene in this one instance and then suddenly go away. The second implication underneath this is also it doesn't allow for long-term sustainability because you don't allow for the root cause of it, the issues happen. The reason why Southeast and Asian countries don't have access to water now is much more about the way that the drought and pollution happens. It means there's alternate casualties to the way that the app happens. Ultimately, it's just a cry. We'll see underneath here. And if we can win in the alternate casualties to the impacts our immense, it means that the app is absolutely just called for the extinction of the way that liberalism is able to sustain itself and becomes try or die for the all.
Well, we say that cruel optimism is the constant belief that the state can somehow act ethically for individuals, right? Individuals begin to believe that the state can somehow do something that is ethical, and they begin to believe in the state. Cruel optimism is the state of believing in the state, but the state is one that is constantly never actually giving you back the form of optimism you have. So,
does the alternative get rid of the state?
The alternative does not get rid of the state. We say that the literal subjecthood produced by the affirmative is one of cruel optimism, and we should.
What is liberalism?
I don't think that we're getting offense out of the state of focus of what liberalism is.
Your entire case is liberalism. Can you tell me what that is?
Yeah, so liberalism is best described by a status notion of politics that says that we ought to do something good in a notion without understanding the underlying assumptions of those. All of our links serve as definitions for what liberalism is.
Where does liberalism start? Like, when did it start historically?
That's not a part of it. Like, where it started doesn't.
I have a minute.
But like,
where it started doesn't matter.
Is it like a Western thing though, or is it?
I mean, yeah. Liberalism is definitely a Western legal.
So like, in Asiatic nations, they don't believe in doing good things for people.
That's not what liberalism is.
What is it then?
Liberalism is a Western belief that individuals should cede agency to the state, and the state should give them.
Don't they do that in non-Western nations?
I mean, yes, but it's a Western legal framework. It's sure it exists in Eastern countries,
but they didn't have like during feudalism, they didn't have to cede their agency to the king, despite that not being like a Western
history. Look, I think that you're misunderstanding politics from history, right? Or argument is that
do you not have like a historical reference to politics?
I mean, sure, but we're talking about two different things.
Also, you said it's a question of worldviews. If your worldview is bad because it's liberal, that means we don't have to win a historical starting point for when it happened. It's just that you're bad.
Okay. It's going to be topicality. Then it will be the app in order. So it'll be the app in order in the top case. Advantage one, advantage two, and then it will be the criticism in the order of the alternative, the framework, the links, and the impacts. And on top of case, I have the peacekeeper's bad arguments flowed on advantage one. That's what it was said in the LOC, so I will be answering those on advantage one, but then explaining why they're not on that advantage. Does that make sense?
It's gonna be
I'm trying to fix the LOC, which had been on the other advantage. So I'll let you know, right? Sorry. First, we only provide money if I have for developing nation states on the behalf we build develop water, which means that we are all we need interpretation, next account interpretation, funding is money provided for a particular purpose, funding is money provided for a particular purpose from your west from your west we have this interpretation because we are funding provided for a particular purpose next year interpretation is bad because that would allow the firm to literally just put money anywhere and not even have the country use it, meaning they would expose the firm to ground and destroy negative access to the main access. Reason for first we say the bright line we say that being able to have funding provided for a particular purpose ensures that a firm is top goal and that the money actually goes to the water filtration and production. Need that. It's gonna be better for all your limits, arguments, and limits. We say you overlimit the affirmative, explode the affirmative limit ground, and remove the affirmative literally is able to just run times of money, which means that you would not be able to have access to more. Like, if an extra argument is that it's going on a potential abuse, like putting on a potential disad, this exists. We have not limited anything to generate a disad, but also we say you should do it for relents of reasonability. If we have a counter interpretation or defense on standards, you should vote for an also for better phenomenon, specific education, where we're actually ensuring that the affirmative has to have the particular purpose be to the water filtration and production. First, I say ethics to our Western concept, absolutely not. We say that religions such as Buddhism have specific kinds of ethical outlook, which means that your perception of ethics being a Western concept is essentialized individuals who are not Western, which means that you would lead to struggle with violence in a world where you assume that everything is through a Western pure dime, ignoring those who operate outside of it. Another argument you say you can't find ethics, we say ethics are things that we evaluate as good or bad in certain societies. You operate under this in your criticism, meaning that you in the space we're able to interrogate what ethics are. We actually have like stable definitions of what ethics are in the space, and world where criticism also operates on a good bad framework. Next, makes you see. How about says that you as a sustainable system, I will get this on the alternatives. Why? If you don't solve this policy, your alternative is not able to resolve the affirmative. But that's why dismantling from the side state is better. But next, are you say, without dismantling, can't solve the app? No, say the app needs some sort of state interrogation in order to be able to resolve this. On the next one, on your peacekeeping bag. You say you should evaluate the description of historical versus prescriptive. No, we say that we should be able to make predictions based on probability analysis. That's important in terms of international politics, where we cannot predict the future. But many scientists, many international political scientists can make predictive outlines based on society. We say that the reason these groups have been ruled out is because the credibility in the fields where they have power a dynamic over individuals and in populations in certain areas, meaning that it's important for credibility to really increase you, actually increase mental health. Trust in the region to be able to check back for peacekeepers. Next argument, you say the impacts of the affirmative would not be allowed to long term stability. I want to cross by all the assaults of the affirmative here. Literally, Muscle Peace says that you can just put the pots in the area and people in the communities build them and they get to stay there forever. I mean, this is the only long term access that would have ever existed, which means that is true, that temporary access is a tool of liberalism. We are the link to your criticism in a world where we are able to resolve the temporary access that Western institutions would do for people. Next argument, you say that you don't resolve the root cause of issues of drought pollution are true. It is imperative for the affirmative to happen now in a world to ensure that people have access to water. But also, you say there's all causes in the app. Like, if there's all causes of answers why, if all causes do happen, you haven't read any. But also, if drought and pollution are true, it's really important. Also, we say that water filtration is really good to be able to check back for more sustainable measures, which means that people are no longer increasing the amount of pollution if we're focused on sustainable measures. Advantage two, advantage one, go entirely conceded otherwise, except across the impacts on here. If we can win that the app is good, then we would win the current on the, okay. On the alternate. Versus recommendation, do the plan as rejection into the 180s attacking the liberal subject. Do the plan as rejection into the 180s attacking the liberal subject. Number one is that this subject position is also a laboratory synthesis of their ideas, which is more meaningful than the alternative itself. But so when he is that, it's important people understand the way the liberal subject to it exists from older games to reject it itself. Within itself is the ultimate implosion of liberalism, which is the most effective way to be able to dissolve itself and be the perfection of more preferable than the alternative, and then just to reject the extra game is. Or rejection alternatives are really bad. Number one is that rejection of it assumes that there has to be a static point, which means a dynamic approach to politics can always be proclivity, or proclivity, which always leads to forms of dichotomies, binaries, which will lead to structural violence. Next, the next predication. Reject the 1AC's attachment to liberal subjecthood and vote affirmative to endorse the ethic of water filtration, or access to clean water, excuse me. Reject the 1AC's attachment to liberal subjecthood and vote affirmative to endorse the ethic of access to water. So many that we preclude for validity, there's an economy between the alternative and the affirmative that the negative tries to tell you, saying that there is a binary that is between themselves, which means that all individuals who fall outside of the binary are between one way, inevitably be pushed out, which is structural violence, repression, affirmations, and results of the world where we're able to understand that there are ways of fluidity can be interrogated through different mechanisms. Liberals can be interrogated also. The chart is that you don't solve the affirmative right. Liberals will literally eat you up in a world where you just reject it one instance, meaning that there was no articulation to how this one reduction can be able to resolve. We say liberalism is going to be inevitable, meaning you have to potentially solve this next chart. It's a dumb line. Either the alternative is strong enough to be able to overcome the one limited plan, or the alternative would never be able to solve all of liberalism. It is true that liberalism is a huge ass Western thing. That means that the permutation is going to be able to resolve and overcome one. Like this, you see, the permutation is masking cool optimism. We say cool optimism doesn't happen. Number one is because optimism leads to a positive loop where individuals feel so that they can be happy and more constructive of themselves in the future. Meaning cool optimism doesn't happen, but actually you're more motivated to make better changes in the future based on how we've done in the past. Meaning that we are at better records making a fighting little soul of optimism on the right word for sure. Do you need anything else, sir?
Just out of asterization, like not acknowledging war ethics or.
Oh, yeah. Just out of asterization, somebody is that the assumption that liberalism only operates from Western campaign assumes that Western campaigns are the only lens by which we can view populations. Some would be this is the justification of disposable populations and social hierarchies based on the Western lens of bodies, and also endorses the Western form of a code of ethics. However, persecution is able to resolve by understanding that liberalism can come from different spheres and is able to resolve the questions of where ethics like are. They're not just all Western. Nothing is just as Western. Blah, blah, blah. Also, the UN isn't Western. You haven't made that argument. 196 countries. That'd be a new argument, so, further. You cross-legged articulation about how ethics inform epistemology here, which means it's why the ask a prior question, but also, you should be able to weigh the affirmative against criticism. You say there's no way to evaluate without a valid epistemology. No, we say the way that we are able to frame things for good and bad, the way that we endorse them, or ways that we that shape our epistemology, you need to know a certain context by which we can validate things for ourselves, which means that it's important that you should be able to weigh the affirmative. You say the criticism is the reason why the ethics of the act are bad, if we went link towards or the reputation is evidence that the ethics are good, or if we went case in which ethics are good, because the PMC has all been about doing awesome things on the first argument that links to the remission are bad. Number one, instead of forcing the affirmative to be able to prep against literally everything that the negative could provide, the affirmative would be forced to talk about every single structural oppression that would exist outside the topic, which would explode affirmative ground, but also means that the affirmative puts an unfair burden to ensure objectives for reasons for education, next argument is a broken system politics term. We actually decrease the amount of broken system politics by being able to ensure that there are permanent positive solutions for individuals by using Potter's piece. They're literally an NGO that is awesome for being able to develop a method mechanism by which communities can become more sustainable and get the F away from Western liberalism. Next argument is turn. We actually decrease the amount of cool optimism that would exist across public positive feedback argument, but also we actually remove the way that dichotomies exist between Western situations and certain countries. We say that we are actually determined to being able to increase the amount of Western influence on these countries by being able to establish that their economy is developing and ensure that Western individuals will have to go back in there more because they already have the infrastructure and irrigation to be able to resolve it. Also, liberalism is inevitable if it is true that Western states are the reason why liberalism exists. We say that you don't get rid of any states, just because the states and the borders of Western states will always exist. Being liberalism is inevitable. It's only a question of how you carry it. But also, states are inevitable in a world where you say that the power structures in a way that individuals relate to each other are always going to exist. That means that the way that we influence them has to be able to be interrogated. Also, we say as individuals, we are the reason that the superstructures out are influencing our objective to key mechanism by which we are able to dismantle superstructures and interrogate them.
Answer the double bind. That either we extend sovereign, but there's no app solvency because we cause issues like subjectivity.
We don't extend the sovereign because we say, get the hell out, Western people, because the United Nations gives money to Potters for Peace, who are really awesome NGOs. We're able to resolve this, that we, like, get all of this. Also, call for actions are really good in a world where we're able to take action. If we don't take action, that leads to forms of nihilism, which is the impact of your cool optimism argument, but also turn to increase the credibility. It's important to be able to increase the amount of intervention to answer all of these arguments is why peace is your bad. On the impact, we say, your only impact is turning the app, that's your terminalized impact, but we say, the impact is the app, but you are not the root cause of the organization comes from a million other all causes, but probably helping people is the way to resolve that.
App and order criticism. Oh, sorry, top count is top.
Yeah.
Okay. I said T after this, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Just
Wait, so it's going to be criticism then T?
No, T half criticism. I thought I said that, but then...
Wait, one more time.
T half in order criticism.
So T half criticism.
Yeah.
You said TK half.
Yeah. Everybody good?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, top colleague, so the big mean word I want for you don't have any offensive reasons here. Now it's going to the affirmative. The first argument I want is going to be on the framework analysis. I want you to go ahead and extend the fact that the app is not necessarily operative. That means that whenever it comes to weighing the affirmative, you weigh the worldview, meaning if we can win impact terms or link analysis, it says that your worldview or justification for doing the affirmative is one that is flawed, that is a reason to reject your analysis, that's PMC analysis, and a reason why you can vote negative whenever we get to the criticism. Now let's go on to link one, advantage one. I want you to go ahead and extend the argument that says that the app doesn't actually attribute any form of long-term stability because they don't offer any sort of adaptation or actually provide any sort of long-term sustainability, which necessarily means that they put you in a double bind. Either you're going to be in the presence for a really long time, which means that you have to have long-term stability, or you get out as soon as you possibly can, which means that you actually leak the long-term stability. They have not answered this double bind, which means that people aren't seeking to access it. The second argument is going to be that we don't necessarily have to win at all costs. You try to make this link-term argument here that says they put it from there and they're getting out as a link-term because we resolve it, but our argument is going to be that you have to require long-term presence. Advantage 2 says that peacekeepers are key to make sure they have access to it. That means that peacekeepers are going to be in the region for a really long time. That's probably thinking if we're going to be a link why we're going to be turning advantage 1. Now it's going to advantage 2. You fundamentally consider the reason why peacekeepers are bad. You can't just say peacekeepers are good and not give a warrant. Our argument is going to be the peacekeepers are necessarily bad in context of water because they put Calaria in the water in the 1990s for the same type of justification for the affirmative, which necessarily puts them in their own mind either. Therefore, peacekeeping is one that's going to be historically key. It's going to be historically accurate because peacekeepers have done this before, or you don't get any more access to this mix because you've not read a reason why the peacekeepers should necessarily be good. The EMT has mixed it into reason or given a warrant for why peacekeepers are necessarily good. We're also going to be one of many reasons why peacekeepers are necessarily bad because it increases the amount of United Nations presence in the area, which necessarily reintroduces the form of liberalism. You have conceded the fact that Western legal frameworks operate in a way in which continues a constant war in the non-West, which means the intervention of the affirmative is simply justified under the gaze of cruel optimism, saying that things will get better, but actually just reintroduces the same form of violence. Haiti is going to become a huge impact failure here. Look, they don't get to say we can make predictions and not make an actual fucking prediction about what would change.
Also, answer the argument that increased credibility means that peacemakers get bad. Like, what the hell does that mean?
Also, they've never given a warrant for why necessarily increasing credibility would mean that peacekeepers are necessarily better. You also haven't given a reason for why peacekeepers would be better or how credibility is internally, which probably means you held them to a low threshold whenever it comes to solvency for the man. So I want to criticism. On the permutation, we have six independent arguments. The first argument to be the both permutations are either separate. The separate or intrinsic was an independent voting issue for argument responsibility because it incorporates portions of the alternative of the affirmative voting. We either severally justification of the affirmative would necessarily mean to make it intrinsic. The second argument is going to be the permutation would necessarily link harder to all of our cruel optimism offense because it was it's in the guise that the United Nations was doing something that were good, that was going to disrupt liberalism, would only re-entrench the liberalism into the way this manifests itself. The third argument is going to be that there's a harmonization disadvantage. The permutation is a neoliberal form expansion to accumulate, to entrench the alternative, which necessarily replicates the neoliberal violence because it simply justifies a constant intervention and claiming necessarily things that cause or claiming alternatives that simply feed back into the system. The fourth argument is going to be that all the links prove an ontological commitment to the form of liberalism, which means that any risk of a link means that the permutation wouldn't necessarily resolve into the offense of the criticism. The fifth argument is going to be you functionally conceded that liberalism is unsustainable, which means that the permutation would necessarily cling to that collapse and necessarily accumulate an extinction before any sort of impacts of the affirmative, which means you hold the permutation to a high threshold. The sixth argument is going to be that you don't get any sort of access. Oh, also, fifth, the uniqueness argument about liberalism being unsustainable answers the juxtaposition. We'll get there in a second. The sixth argument is going to be you don't get any and you don't get to make any arguments about the permutation necessarily being good for activism or being able to incorporate any sort of change because you created a bad form of activism. That's going to be all the link level analysis. Thoughts on the permutation. On my right, you said juxtaposition. Two different arguments. The first argument is going to be that the harmonization disadvantage is going to turn this argument, say the harmonization and constant desire to necessarily position yourself against something is one that allows neoliberalism to simply manifest itself. You said the permutation is huge critical for liberalism to collapse upon itself, first of all, you're going to give more to the MGP markets to get a new calculation. The second number is going to be that necessarily accelerates the inevitable collapse of liberalism, which causes extinction. You've conceded the impact analysis, which means you get them no access to this argument. Obviously, you say that the rejection is necessarily that because it's a static point in politics. We say that we've read Link articulation says that your form of liberalism is something that's to be rejected, not rejection in and of itself, which means you don't get access to it. The second argument is going to be that you don't have an impact for necessarily why rejection is going to be out, which means a high threshold for this NPTE market. The third argument is going to be rejection, that's very key if we can win all of our Link analysis, which means that the alternative is a prerequisite to avoiding the impacts of the alternative. The second permutation.
They say that rejection is bad because of like binaries. We will say that there should be no space of binary if liberalism exists.
There would be no space of binary if liberalism didn't exist. On to the second permutation.
This permutation literally makes no sense. It's the exact same as the first permutation necessary. It means that all of the offenses necessary are linked to it. Now you say that we simply allow for the outside, which pushes out alternation. Our argument is going to be that liberalism is a constant war that pushes out peripheral violence, which necessarily accelerates its collapse and inevitably causes extinction. You can see the impact analysis. The second argument is going to be that you make this double bind that says that the alternative can overcome the static, can't overcome the planner, doesn't result in the status quo. We don't have to win that the alternative would change the status quo. Rather, just rejecting the affirmative in of itself is something that is good. That is your framework analysis that you functionally continue. You also make this cruel optimism isn't true because you offer constructivism argument. I'm going to make two different arguments. The first argument to be you can see that cruel optimism simply lapses people into a constant state in which they're desiring for more control. This means that you can use agency from a disciplinary to a control society in which individuals believe that the sameness is really has the ability to control the outcome of their life, which necessarily breeds nihilism and turns this argument on its head. Now let's go into the framework argument. You make this
ahistorical argument.
The first argument that we this ahistorical argument literally makes no sense. We don't say that necessarily liberalism is something that's ahistorical, but rather liberalism is an ongoing process. That's the alternative argument. It says that we need a constant rejection of liberalism to make sure that we result that. We said the alternative is necessary to be key. We're also not saying that we're not making these sort of arguments about Western. We say that liberalism is a Western legal framework that is being justified by the affirmative of the United Nations. We don't have to win that the United Nations is Western, just that they're using a Western legal framework to all our legal levels analysis of. Now you say
that's fine. Let's go on to the framework.
You say that the affirmative is a prior question, but you can see the underpinnings necessarily come first, which means that any risk of a link is the reason why the affirmative is in a prior question. Now you say that you should weigh the affirmative. I've done that. We're going to the affirmative. The framework, you don't get access to this argument because you don't actually figure out anything, because you don't resolve anything that's a question world. You're not going to link level analysis. You say that links have omissions are bad. Cool, we don't get a link of omission. The second argument is going to be that you folks can see that the fact affirmative is a cruel form of cruel optimism. I've done this work all over the case law, which means that.
No, we did evaluate this enough for a stable interpretation. Their statements mean nothing.
You also repeat a stable interpretation, which means that your statements mean nothing. You say that you actually decrease of broken foreign policies, but our only global analysis says that you simply extend the United Nations sovereignty over a country. They get to decide that only Southeastern countries or Southeastern Asian countries or whatever are the countries that necessarily get access to water, which re-entrenches individuals into a constant form of cruel optimism because they believe the United Nations will eventually do something, which is a constant guide for the United Nations extensionism. We say that you decrease cruel optimism, you give warrants, and we have said that you're actually a bad form of cruel optimism because you constantly have individuals thinking that the state's going to do something for them, and it really lapses into it. Also, even if you decrease cruel optimism, you accelerate liberalism, terminal collapse. You say you remove the Western concept. We don't say that you don't remove the West, you just let the West go back in. You say that liberalism is the number. Cool, that doesn't answer our argument. Our argument is going to be that your foreign politics of liberalism is necessarily bad, which means that we don't have to win that we dismantle all liberalism. Just under your world, we should reject it. You say that action is good. I've already answered that argument with the impact turn above about problems. You say that you increase credibility, but you don't actually increase credibility. I've done that work on the case, so you don't actually make it. You make it worse for the individuals living in the country.
Cool, is anyone not ready? I usually put the all on the new page, but like your entire, if you're like stuck to it, it'll be the link page, the alternative, and then some app comparison. Make sense?
Yeah, I mean, you're just gonna overview, that's all I needed.
Okay. Anyone not ready? You vote Texas Tech GK today because the criticism outweighs and turns all of the app. We are indicting three conceded lead turns that will serve as terminal defense they've conceded, which also will serve as amplifiers to make the app happens. The first that they are conceding is that you have conceded that you absolutely cede agency to the state, which means that you should ask yourself at the end of the
debate. For whom do these impacts mean anything? You've conceded this from the jump street of the LOC, which means that if it is true that we still get access to water and solving of genocide, it happens still at the questions of Western legal framework. You are not responsive to this argument, which means that we should ask ourselves, why is it that the justification happens in a world in which we must supersede our agency? That changes the paradigms for the way that you should evaluate impacts and is not responsive and will be quickly point of order in PMR. The second is that of cruel optimism. We are absolutely extending this leak term because your only answer to this is that you decrease the way that cruel optimism happens. You have not indicted the fact that the people get locked into status quo notions of policies and then they reinscribe to this. That's a liberal subjective order, which means that you absolutely will not be able to have it. The third argument is you've also conceded that liberalism is terminally unsustainable. The NG answers this criticism like we're in 2011 without looking at the shell by just reading a bunch of claims about how the state is inevitable without answering your argument. That means this. Look, slow down for a second. The PMR has two options, right? They can either go for these link turns, which are hogwash, and you should hold them accountable for how much they talk about them in the NG because they make no sense, or it means that they go for these state or inevitable claims. Both of those are non-responsive to the fact that liberalism is unsustainable now, which means that even if the app could do something in a short-term interim, they absolutely lead to the acceleration of the collapse of liberalism. We have articulated from Jump Street that liberalism produces an ontological category of disposable populations, which makes that the app unpredictable and not able to solve, which means that the app has framed this from the very beginning to be a question of impeding worldviews, right? But they aren't answering the criticism like that's the framework that they read. They're answering it like they just read a policy app. We are articulating that because liberalism creates an ontological category of the non-other, it means that there's absolutely no way that the app can solve. There is not responded to at all in the MG, which means that you give them little to zero access on framing the app against the LOC and the PMR because they have just missed these questions, which is not true.
They also don't have an argument that says that their form of liberalism is good.
Right. They also don't have a single link term that says that their form of liberalism is good. The link terms are only indicative of the fact that they are able to produce some decreasing of liberalism and that is inevitable. Our articulation is not an answer this articulation not an answer to the LOC shell, which is why the LOC will absolutely be able to resolve all the offense. The other alpha they have here is the permutation with their weird juxtapositions and rejection politics. First off is that you should absolutely 100% evaluate all of the permutations through the conceded articulation that liberalism is unsustainable now, which means that any attachment of the permutation with liberalism would only accelerate the collapse of liberalism, which makes disposable populations inevitable now. You are not responsive to this articulation, which means that the app would not be able to solve. The second is that these permutations also would lead to a harmonization disad. You should ask yourself, why is it in the history of forever has the UN been historically talked about as being someone who is bad for international corporations? You are not responsive to that articulation, which means that harmonization, the liberal subject order, would almost always influence the way that we are able to characterize and able to understand this discursive politics. It means that the app is absolutely a prior question. Look, final question for you. At the end of the debate, you have to resolve this. The app will try to weigh themselves either in the permutation or the criticism. Ask yourself, is any of the offense the PMR attempts to go for indicative of the fact that liberalism is unsustainable now, or is it responsive to the fact that liberalism cedes our agency to the state before we have impacts?
Case in the order of this red. On that, you will need the link sheet of the criticism. I don't know if you have a computer or anything. There's an argument made there. I'll pass it on.
Wait, start again. I wasn't listening.
Sorry. Case in order. On advantage two, you're going to need an argument that is on the links of the criticism. On advantage two. Yeah. And then we'll be going through the criticism in the order of the alternative framework links that have.
Wait, what's the order on the K?
Alternative, links, frameworks, and facts.
All links, frameworks, and facts?
All the frameworks.
Okay.
You will be voting for Pacific Indian tribes to ensure access to potable water for hundreds of millions of people living in the South Asian region, especially when the negative is necessarily conceded that they do not solve the case, which makes it a giant disadvantage to the alternative. We go to case now. The only arguments I need from the top case is the question, the second argument that the ethics form is involved, which necessarily needs to always be a required question because the way that it works to the other is necessarily key in terms of understanding the petition, the question of how ethical bad ways to come to the discussion that benefits I understanding the amount of lives that we necessarily save, which means that we're good on this question of epistemology. But now I want to go down to the actual solvency of plain text. To be clear, all the plain text does is fund an organization, not the UN, to go into this region and teach them how to create sustainable factories. We do not send in peacekeepers. That was the internal link scenario on Advantage 2, which means you're probably not going to get any game on this when we told you as to why Potter's for peace is necessarily good. Let's go to Advantage 1 now. Advantage 1 is fundamentally considered the only argument they have to bring out a question of long solvency, but you can consider the argument that says they necessarily go in and train, they go in and are able to train these people on how to develop these facilities and that it's sustainable and it only costs $5 every 2 years. All of the materials are locally sourced and they are done by the community themselves, not by the UN, not even by Potters for Peace. They simply go in and train the people with peace. Now, we're not going to be linking to any of your positions. We do have evidence of risk of sustainability, but it's also a question that you can see that these are an effective technology. You can see that the result for 99.99% of all the disease that is occurring as a result of get to the impact. We retain that we put 4 million people dying every single year, and 1.6 million children dying from things like diarrhea, and 842,000 people died in 2012. All of those lives that we save are reasons why, from a net beneficial lens, which we told you is key to ethics and epistemology, you would prefer the affirmative. There are no arguments made as to how they actually solve for Advantage 1. Don't garner any offense on this page, meaning it's all ours. Advantage 2 is where you need this argument from the links page. Last argument they made is all we need on this question. You say that our increase in credibility would not necessarily work for the UN peacekeepers, right? Because that means UN peacekeepers will never go into a war where we didn't actually increase the UN's credibility, which means you don't have any offense on this question. You shouldn't have made that you are giving in the block. We don't send in peacekeepers. It was an internal link scenario that says that if our plan was reviewed in a positive way, that would increase credibility, which would justify people supporting more peacekeepers. But you said that doesn't happen because we don't have their credibility, which means there's no link to any of your offense. Go to the criticism on the alternative debate. On the alternative debate, we'd be going for the first permutation because the plan's a really good idea. The first thing I want to resolve is this question of signature intrinsic. There's no reason as to why we're signature intrinsic. I hate that we include the entirety of the plan and we don't add any words in terms of the alternative or the plan text. That necessarily means that this is entirely theoretically legitimate, which means it's just a question of winning office. I want to win some office on this right now. This is the question of the next position. I hate the sentence question of the amateur without a laboratory of synthesis. I hate understanding the way that the superstructure, I hate the government institutions, the liberal institutions that you talk about, are able to indict themselves. I hate that this is a question of being able to solve from within the system as opposed to from outside of it. But additionally, there's like a double bind issue here that is all over the block. Their argument is one, they concede neoliberalism is inevitable, or rather, liberalism is inevitable, kind of got changed there. But two, they say it's on the brink of collapse. Only one of these things can be true. We will be winning arguments to say that it's ultimately inevitable. First reason we say it's ultimately inevitable, you have necessarily conceded that states are inevitable, which always means that their world continues to exist, meaning these Western structures are not resolved. You'd only necessarily be able to solve the speech type, but when our speech type is we'd have to based on the fact that we save billions of lives, this articulation as to why you're not good on this question. Notice our harmonization is that they say we ultimately lead to replication of co-optation, but additionally, our lens of constant intervention. No, that is what the UN would do typically, but instead, we send in people literally one time who aren't even a part of the UN, and they create a sustainable infrastructure. This is the fundamental change we have articulated. Literally, that was the story on Advantage 1 that we changed from the hard power focus to justification of being able to allow other individuals to work in a model of community sustainability. But additionally, I want you to go down to the question of number three argument from Dallas under after the Burns was you don't solve for the affirmative. One rejection of us doesn't solve for Advantage 1. No explanation as to how this is true. If we have one that net benefits our reason to prefer us on this question, that means you prefer us saving millions of lives, even hypothetically, to the question of them resolving for the single instance of liberalism, especially when they can see that liberalism is necessarily inevitable. I want you to drop down to the question of a historization. We say it's also a question of not understanding the positing of ethics. Like, you've tried to label some as a result of radics being a reason that you prefer fixed models, but you can see that ethics are part of other non-functioning institutions such as Buddhism, which we deny right on this question of the books.
Cruel optimism
stuff. On the question of cruel optimism, we say that you are wrong on the question. One, that we are not cruel optimism. We are just standard optimism. Mind that we are able to change the system by constantly engaging with it rather than wiping our hands of it via one projection. But additionally, it's also a question of future solvency. We say that you have to be within that structure. You have to consider the individual influence of the superstructure, which means you have to be able to resolve all the questions. Go to the options on the links. Briefly, we've won that ethics for epistemology not here. Go to one, sorry. I want you to send down specifically the arguments that question have already made about the question of the superstructure being formed by the individual, which essentially means that our individual orientation has to be key to this position. The last term that we wrote, I have the question that we were able to solve. That the perm is actually a positive conclusion of this. We aren't the UN going in with peacekeepers. We are supporting community sustainability, which means you're not linking to any of your local analysis.